Hello everyone, this is Paul and you are watching Billy's Educatela. In this today video session, I would like to discuss the topic of Java constructors. Before going to the video, do subscribe my channel, like the video and press the bell icon for my notifications. Now let us discuss the topic of Java constructors. Coming to the introduction part of Java constructors, what is a Java constructor? A Java constructor is nothing but a block of code that initializes a newly created object. So, when an object is created, that particular object is initialized by using some particular block of code. That particular block of code is known as a constructor. What is the syntax for an object? So, the syntax for an object is, first we are going to declare the class name. So here I consider the class name as my class. So my class, I am taking the object name as obj. So for initializing this object, we are going to create one particular method. That method name is known as new my class of. So this particular method or this initialization of the object is known as a constructor. So here we created a method. This method represents a constructor. A constructor resembles an instance method in Java, but it is not a method as it doesn't have any return type. So here new my class of represents that it is a type of method, but it is not a method because it doesn't have a return type. A method is a set of code which has some return type, but this particular constructor doesn't have a return type. So here I created a constructor named as my class. So you may notice that the class name and the constructor name are as it is. So the main case when we are creating a constructor is the name of the constructor and the class name should be equal. So here the class name and the constructor name are as it is. And coming to the second point, all classes have the constructors by default. If you didn't created any constructor, the computer itself or the Java program itself creates a default constructor. So the main use of Java constructors is by default they are called and they are used and gives an output to the user. I hope you understood. If you do not create a constructor, Java creates one for you. So here this point shows that if you doesn't create a constructor, Java will create a constructor for you. So based on these points, we divide these constructors into three types. One is default constructor. So this default constructor is called by computer itself. And the second one is no argument constructor. So the constructor in which we doesn't have any arguments is known as no argument constructor. And the third one is parameterized constructor. So in this constructor, we are going to give some parameters to the particular attributes. So attributes are nothing but the variables which we are going to take the inputs and give the outputs to the user. Now let us discuss the use of the constructor and the difference between a constructor and a method. So here I am creating a object named as xobj. So x represents the class name and obj represents the object name. So xobj is equals to new x of. So here new x of is a constructor which is in the form of a method. But the main difference between a constructor and a method is a method has a return type, but a constructor doesn't have a return type. So for initializing this particular object, we use a constructor. So the main purpose of the constructor is to initialize the object of a class, while the purpose of a method is to perform a task by executing the Java code. But in methods, we have some particular task and that task has to be executed. Now let us explain each of the constructors. First one is the default constructor. What is a default constructor? the constructor in which the computer calls the constructor itself is known as a default constructor. So if the user doesn't provide any constructor, the computer will provide the constructor to the particular code and runs the program and gives the output to the user. So here is an example. Here I have a class name and the main method. In this main method, I created an object, but there is no constructor in this particular program. So how the computer will convert this particular program? By using the default constructor. So the compiler will convert this particular program into this way. So here you may observe that, so here the computer will call the default constructor and creates a particular constructor by using my clause of. So in that my class, we doesn't have any data. So it will run it and gives the output to the user. So for initializing a particular object, we have two methods. My class object name is equals to new my class of, or else you can simply write new my class of. So here new my class of represents a particular method, that means which shows a constructor is created, and this new my class of is used to initialize that particular object. I hope you understood. Coming to the second one is no argument constructor. The constructor in which we doesn't have any arguments in that particular constructor is known as no argument constructor. So here is an example. Here we have a class named as X. By using that class name, we created a constructor named as SumX. So in that particular constructor, I am going to print some data. So here I am printing the data, but you can observe that there are no arguments. That means we doesn't initialize any variables in this particular constructor. So the constructor in which there are no arguments is known as no argument constructor. So you may get doubt that default constructor and no argument constructors are as it is, but the main difference is in no argument constructor we are going to print some matter, but in default constructor we couldn't. I hope you understood. In no argument constructor, we are not giving any arguments, but we can print some data, but in default constructor we couldn't. I hope you understood. Coming to the third one, what is a parameterized constructor? A constructor in which we are going to give some particular parameters to the variables is known as a parameterized constructor. So here in this particular constructor, we are giving some parameters. So here the string name and the int age represent some parameters. So the constructor in which we are giving the parameters is known as a parameterized constructor. So in this class, I am going to take the string student name and int student age. So for getting the student name and student age, I am using this particular constructor. In the main method, when an object is declared, I am going to give the name and the age. So this name and the age are again given to the student name and the age. So I am going to print the student name and the age. So here you can observe that when I am creating the object, I give the inputs to the particular constructor. So these values are given to this string name, and the values are given to student name and the student age, and the values are printed here. So here you may notice that there is no return type. So what is the difference between a method and a constructor means? So here when we are getting the student name and the student age, they are not transferred to any other method. So when this data is transferred to another method, then this statement will become as a method. So we didn't call any return statement here. So a constructor doesn't support a return type. So if I construct a constructor by using void a of, means it shows that void is of return type. So here we doesn't create a constructor, but we created a method. When we are initializing a constructor, we doesn't use any void type, because void shows a return type. So when we are constructing a constructor, we must use only the particular class name. I hope you understood. If you have any doubts, comment below, like the video and share the content which is present in my channel, and subscribe my channel. Thank you everyone.